Hello, and welcome to Google Keep. This is a quick overview that's going to let folks who are already familiar with the G Suite for Education series of applications get more used to one of Google's better kept secrets. So, Google Keep can be easily found by going to Google Apps once you're logged into your Google account, scrolling down until you find the telltale light bulb shaped icon, which is on a yellow sticky note. Once you click on that, you'll be at your notes page. There are multiple ways to take these notes. The simplest is to click where it says take a note and take a note. You can add a title. And you can color code it. Once a note's done, you can do multiple things with it. You can pin it if it's really important and you want to see it every time you go to your notes. You can also add reminders if you need to check in on that note later in the day or later in the class, and add collaborators through email if you wish to work together on something else. The key aspect of Google Keep, it's like a collaborative notebook or a collaborative project notebook. You can also add images. You can archive it for later if it's very important, or you can add labels, drawings, make copies, copy to Google Docs if you're already using those kind of things, which I just did. And you can make other kinds of notes as well. So if you're more for using this for organization and for keeping you or your students organized, click New List. You can use this as a simple checklist. It's pretty straightforward, but it's also satisfying. Once you click on a task, it is crossed out. You can also undo it if you click that accidentally. You can also switch tasks around if you need to get the order quite right. If you are more creatively minded or are in some sort of art class, you can take a note using some drawings. For this, I'm just going to draw a face, check mark, because that's how you should feel. Happy that you understand how to use Google Keep. You can also take textual notes. And attach those. Once you're done, you can add additional drawings, add a label, which is great for organizing. Say this belongs to class one, and say this task list belongs to class two. You can organize them, and when you go to those labels, it'll pull them right up. Now, important things to remember, some of the other secrets of Google Keep are the settings. Right now I'm on dark mode. If you don't prefer dark mode, switch back. You can also use keyboard shortcuts, which are great for folks who are not comfortable with a keyboard and mouse, or folks who just want to use Google Keep as quickly and efficiently as possible. You don't necessarily have to memorize these, but they could be helpful. Besides for that, remember that Google Keep is all about collaborative note-taking. Get creative. Have your students take pictures and save them as notes and write what they're thinking about it. Or just have them create one for each one of their classes or class projects. You could use this to create a collaborative summary of a story that you're reading, or when visiting a museum, to take quick pictures or draw drawings of things that you see and how students feel about it. There's lots of different ways to use this. You can find some of our suggestions on the Online Tools for Teaching and Learning website, as well as a full breakdown of what we think about Google Keep, ranging from privacy issues to accessibility. We hope you enjoyed. Check out other applications on our website, and good luck.